Okay, very good. So we can express the band pass signal in canonical form as what? S of t is equal to si of t into cosine of 2 pi fc t minus s2 of t into sine of 2 pi fc t. Right? I said si of t is the in phase component of the band pass signal s of t, and sq of t is the quadrature phase component of the signal s of t. Okay? So we have discussed it till that. Yeah. Just I will give one example how this has been implemented and useful in the design of communication system. This in phase and quadrature component means how do they think of these in phase and quadrature components, and what they mean that how the real part of the band pass signal is only transmitted over the air. Okay, just to have that, let me write this diagram. So I need to say in phase component and quadrature component, right? Two inputs. So let me take so this is my in phase signal, that is what I can read, say si of t. Okay, similar to that I have another component, that is quadrature component. So that quadrature component is what? The complex quantity, what I said, J into SQ of T, right? So in a nutshell, it is an S tide of T. You all agree with me? Can I write SI of T plus J into SQ of T as S tide of T? Yes or no? Because I said S tide of T can be expressed in a rectangular form, right? Is like the si of t plus j into sq of t. Okay, so which is going to be multiplied by a complex carrier. Okay, so that complex carrier, I can write it here. So which is nothing but, see, s tide of t is multiplied by what? The complex exponential, na? That is e power what? J 2 pi fct. Yes, you all agree with this? See, S tide of t into e power j 2 pi fct. So I say e power j 2 pi fct is the what? Complex carrier signal. Okay, which is multiplied by the complex envelope of the band pass signal. The resulting signal, what I can say is what? S tide of t, right, into e power j 2 pi f c t. Just modulation is happening here. See, multiplication of these two things is nothing but modulation, right? Then what I mean to say is, I will be transmitting the real part of this. What is the real part of this signal? Real part of, just I'm putting in dot. The dot is nothing but what? This one, S of t. Okay. Which will be transmitted over the antenna. So this is the standard which is followed in industry. Okay. They go with in phase and quadrature components only. So implementation wise, it becomes easy. Okay, so the real part of this will be about band pass signal. So which is a modulated signal, which will be transmitted over the air. What I wanted to say is here. So real and imaginary baseband signals will be modulated by, so this is the real part, right? And this is the imaginary part of the baseband signal, which will be modulated by what? The complex carrier, right? And then the it will be transmitted, what component? The real component of this. Okay, so real component of this is what? That is SFT, okay? Yes, I said S of T will be what? Real part of S tied of T into E4J2πfct, no? Right? So the complex envelope, that is S tied of T, we can picture, it may be pictured as the time varying phasor, right? Positioned at the origin of this plane SI and SQ. Okay? So let me. Right, so this expression, what I wanted to say is S of T, I said the real part of this S tied of T into E4J2πfct. I said this may be pictured as what? Time varying phasor, which is positioned at the origin of what plane? SI and SQ plane. SI is in real axis and SQ is in the imaginary axis. Okay. So just just hope you are understanding what I am saying. The equation, what I said, S of T is equal to real part of what? S tied of T into e power j 2 pi fct. Okay. I said the complex envelope, na? That is S tied of T. I expressed that in Cartesian form of what? In the Cartesian form as Si of T plus j into Sq of T. You all know what we are going to write in x axis and what we are going to write in y axis. So that only I am saying here. Okay. So with respect to that, any one of you, is it possible to say so this is my which one? Okay, so this is the origin and this is my what component? I said this will be the real axis, right? So this is my SI and this will be what? SQ. Okay, and I said it is a time varying phasor, right? And this is the origin. So from this point I can write the time varying phasor. Okay, usually we denote like this, na? Time varying phasor, right? So with what angle I can say? Should be a straight line. Okay. Yeah. So what is this angle? Yes, any one of you can say, and what is its magnitude? Yes, see the equation is very simple. I said S tied of T will be equal to what I said? Si of T plus j into sq of t, right? So what I am saying, I can picture this complex envelope. Okay, complex envelope may be pictured as what I said, time varying phasor, right? Positioned at the origin, okay, of what plane? SI and sq plane. Okay, so this is my time varying vector. What is its magnitude and what is the angle? You all know how to write the magnitude and angle of this, if it is in the form of a plus jb, it is in the form of a plus jb only, right? You can treat a as si of t and b as sq of t. So its magnitude will be what? Yes, I expect answer for this. It is all very simple things, no?
Root of
si of t square plus sq of t square.
Yeah, square root of what? Square root of
si of t square.
Yeah, s square I plus, I can say, s square q. Okay, so this is my magnitude. What is this angle? This angle will be what?
Sq
tan inverse of
sq of t by si of t.
Yeah, tan inverse of sq by si. Okay, see, instead of writing a and b, I'm writing some other variables, that's all. Okay, it is in the form of a plus jb only. If I say x is equal to a plus jb, you all will say, what is the magnitude, right? Square root of a square plus b square. Then angle will be tan inverse of b by a. Yes or no? If it is in this form, a plus jb, okay, you people will easily tell what is its magnitude and what is its phase angle, right? So when the variables are different, why you are hesitating to say? So this is for this one, s tide of t, right? So this function is multiplied by what? E power j 2 pi fct, na? As far as that equation is concerned, right? S of t is equal to what I said, real part of s tide of t into e power j 2 pi fct. So how do we write that e power j 2 pi fct in the phasor form? I think I expect you people to say this. It is very basic and discussed even in the previous semester also. How do I express e power j 2 pi fct in the phasor form? So this is my real axis. Right? Sorry, and this is the imaginary axis. This is the imaginary axis. Yeah. Hope you're understanding now what I'm saying. E power j 2 pi fct. How do I express that in the phasor form? Yes, any one of you can switch on your camera and present if you have written. Otherwise, I will be keep writing and you will be just noticing. E power j 2 pi fct. How do I express that in the phasor representation? Yes, whatever, when I discussing frequency modulation, right? I think I might have spent hour for this. E power j 2 pi fct. Yes, nobody can recall. Yes, it is also a time varying vector. Okay, so this will be what? This is at what angle here? This is for e power j 2 pi fct, okay, what I am writing. E power j 2 pi fct. Okay, this can be expressed in phasor form like this. So this angle is for 2 pi fct, okay, and this is having a magnitude of 1, right, and this will be rotating. What I can say, this time varying vector will be rotate at the rate of 2 pi fc. It will rotate. This time varying vector will be rotating at what rate? Rotate at the rate of 2 pi fc. You are not aware of this? Very basic thing, okay? So now, what you need to do as per the expression is concerned? So s of t is equal to real part of S tide of t into e power j 2 pi f ct is there, right? So you need to multiply these two phasor diagrams. When you multiply these two phasor diagrams, then the resulting phasor diagram will be the what? Phasor diagram for S of t. You will be able to find out what is the S of t from that diagram. So when I multiply these two phasors, okay, so what is going to happen? Yes, I want just multiplication. When I multiply these two complex vectors, right, these two phasor diagrams, what is going to be added? And I hope you understand, huh? When I multiply these two phasor diagrams, so something is going to be added and something is going to be multiplied. I expect that answer from your side. Yes, these are all very basic questions, yeah.
The angles will get added and the magnitude gets multiplied.
Yeah, angles are getting added. Their magnitudes will be. Yes, what about their lengths? This is the length, no? Length of this vector is square root of s square I plus s square q. And here the length of this vector is 1. So their lengths are going to be multiplied. Okay, and their angles are going to be added. Okay. So the complex envelope S tide of t is multiplied by the complex exponential, complex exponential, what I said, the e power j 2 pi f ct, right? So S tide of t is multiplied by the complex exponential e power j 2 pi f ct. The angles of these two phasors, right, will be added and their lengths will be multiplied. So how do I draw that? Any one of you, can you try to draw this by adding these two angles? And anyhow, once that phasor length is 1, another one is square root of s square I plus s square q. So that into that will be, anything into 1 will be equal to, x into 1 will be equal to x only, right? So their length will be same, their angles will be added. Is it possible to draw? Can you put some effort in this regard? Yes. Hope you noted, na? If I move up, is it fine? Yes, I'm asking if I move up, is it fine? Or still you wanted to note down this?
Sir, wait, sir.
Gentlemen, I need some response, right? Nobody is responding then. Oh, people are able to visualize this when I multiply, how their angles are added, what about their lengths? Their lengths would be multiplied. Means what I mean to say is that is S tide of t is going to be rotated. Okay. Yes, shall I scroll up?
Yes, sir.
I will scroll up, but I expect you people to write the resulting diagram. Okay. At least one or two people should be able to show this. Oh. Yeah. I will give 2 minutes time. 1 or 2 minutes quickly. Any one of you? Yes, in the previous class, other people said that they will be proactive and they will communicate. They should come up on their own. Okay, when I was taking attendance, you people said that, yes, sir, definitely we will be interacting with you in the next class. They should write and they should project the diagram by switching on their camera. Is anyone of you at least trying? Yes, you people only said that their angles will be added, their lengths will be multiplied. Right? Yes, Neeraj, Nishit Jain, what about others? Chandrika. Yes, anybody is trying or simply sitting? Tell me if you have any idea, is it fine? Otherwise, I will say from my side. Hello. Yes, Shreyas, how are you doing?
Yes,
sir. Yen madidya torustiya?
Sir, one second.
What about Chandrika?
So I'm just trying to do, sir.
We're just trying to do. Yes, what about Gayatri?
Yes, sir.
Yes, are you multiplying? I said no, those two, yes, vectors, sir, should be phasor diagrams. When we multiply, yes, their angles will be added, their lengths will be multiplied. I'm asking you people to draw the resulting diagram.
Yes, sir. I'm
are doing you doing that?
Yes, sir. 1 minute.
1 minute. Yes, Nishit Jain. Nishit Jain is there. What about Neeraj?
Yes, sir.
Have you tried, man?
Still figuring it out, sir.
Still figuring it out. Okay. What about Vishal? Vishal. Yes, Sagar.
Doing it, sir.
Yeah, let me write from my side. First, at least people should be able to write the real axis, first case, right? If not anything else. I don't think you are finding any difficulty in drawing this real axis. Okay, you can say this is your real axis. Well, let me point something here. So this is my origin, what I can say. Okay, at least this is one axis, what I can say, this is my, so with respect to this real axis, I can say this angle is 2 pi FCT and this is my SI, okay, and you can draw another that is SQ. So this SI and SQ should be perpendicular to each other, isn't it? Hope you are able to notice that, because they are in phase and quadrature phase components, right? You should draw SI and you write a straight line, okay? And these two, the angle should be of 90 degree. So this is perpendicular. Okay. Hope you're understanding what I'm drawing. Okay. Then what you can do is you can write a time varying phasing vector which is passing through this line. Okay. So this will be what? Having a magnitude of square root of a square I plus a square Q. Okay. And from here, this angle will be what? Tan inverse of S Q by SI. Okay. So if I project this time varying vector now to the real axis, okay, from this point, and this value will be my S of t. Okay, so this is how we represent it in the this one. SI and SQ plane, they are perpendicular to each other, right? In that, it is just rotating, right? With angle of 2 pi FCT from real axis, then from there, with an angle of what? Tan inverse of SQ by SI. What I wanted to say here is the phasor representing the complex envelope, that is S tied of T, will be moving in the SISQ plane, right? While at the very same time, the plane itself will rotate about the origin. Okay, the plane itself will be rotating at the origin. So the original bandpass signal is what? The projection of the time-varying vector, a time-varying phasor on a fixed line representing the real axis. That is why you projected from that the real axis, and I am saying that is the S of t. Okay, so just take time. So with the basic understanding about this phasor, how do we represent, then when I multiply those two phasors, how we are going to get that. So with that basic knowledge only, written this. You don't have to worry too much about this. If it is not getting that much into that, it is okay, no issue. Just at least you will be able to say concept wise, how do I represent S tied of T in the phasor form? How do I represent E 4 J 2 pi F C T in phasor form? Then when I multiply, what I get? Then how do I get the S of T? That understanding should be there. Okay. So with this, let me move to the next concept. That is So let me discuss about the scheme for deriving the in-phase and quadrature components of a bandpass signal. Let us try to understand how do I extract, okay, the in-phase and quadrature component from the bandpass signal.
Sir, can you scroll a bit up, sir?
Yes, ma'am, 1 minute. scheme for deriving the in-phase and quadrature components of a bandpass signal. Yeah, this diagram. I think you can mention SQ. I have not mentioned that. This one is SQ. SI and SQ, they are perpendicular, right? In that plane, it is this phasor is moving. With an angle of tan inverse of SQ by SI.
Yes, sir.
So now let us try to understand how we can derive the in-phase and quadrature phase components of a bandpass signal. So two things, right? One is the in-phase component and another one is the quadrature component. Quadrature component of what I need to find out? Bandpass signal. The in-phase and quadrature component of a bandpass signal. Okay, any idea? Already we know how to express this bandpass signal in a standard form or canonical form, right? So what is that? Yes, any one of you can say, how do we express the bandpass signal in terms of canonical form? In the canonical form, just now I asked today's at the beginning of the class, that is what S of t is equal to SI of t into cosine of 2 pi FCT minus SQ of t into sine of 2 pi FCT, right? So before I draw the diagram, first let me go with the expression. So I said that S of t will be equal to what? SI of t cos of 2 pi FCT, right? Minus SQ of t into sine of 2 pi FCT. So this is my S of t, right? So S of t, from this I need to derive this in-phase and quadrature phase components, Okay, so that is what the meaning of the title is. So how do I do that? So to do that, so that should be the input to the diagram, input to the circuit, right? Whatever the circuit I draw. So what I do is, I split this S of t into two components. Okay. I am splitting this S of t into two components. One is, I am multiplying this S of t by I multiply this S of t by cos. Okay. Let me say okay, I have an oscillator. Okay, it can generate a cosine signal. So this is the oscillator. So it can generate a cosine signal. So let me write that as 2 into with a magnitude of 2. Okay, 2 cos 2 pi fct. Okay. So what will be the output of this multiplier 1? So this is a multiplier, right? In the same way, I am splitting this into another part. Okay. I am taking it here. I am multiplying So what I do is I use another multiplier. Okay, for that I am feeding the 90 degree phase shift signal. When I take the 90 degree phase shift signal, 90 degree phase shifter I am using. So output of this 90 degree phase shifter will be what? It will be minus 2 sine of 2 pi fct. Minus 2 into sine of 2 pi fct. Okay. So this I will be giving to another multiplier. Okay. So let me add this. So I am multiplying the given S of t by what? One with cos, another with sine. Okay. So output of, I need to find out what is the output of multiplier 1 and output of multiplier 2. Just do that. Yes, can you do? What is the output of multiplier 1? Let me say this is a multiplier 1, okay? Multiplier 1, and this is the multiplier 2. Yes, quickly, I expect you people to do that multiplication. You know what is S of t, just now I wrote, no, on top. Right, S of t is SI of t into cosine of 2 pi of ct minus SQ of t into sine 2 pi of ct. So with respect to find the output of the multiplier 1, what you need to do? You have to multiply S of t by 2 cosine of 2 pi of ct. I hope you are able to do that and simplify that. I said,
scroll up a little, sir.
want me to scroll up? Okay, better. I think you will only should do. Then if any difficulties, I will help. Okay, it is very simple. It is basic. This one. Yeah. Is it fine?
Sir, little more near the heading, can I see?
Which one? This one?
One.
Yeah, this is the scheme for deriving in-phase and quarter phase component of a bandpass signal.
Got it, sir.
So here I am saying this is my S of T. Okay, we know what is S of T, how do we express. Then I am asking you people to do what is the output of multiplier 1 and what is the output of multiplier 2. So what I am doing is here I am splitting S of T. Okay, I am multiplying S of T once by cosine signal and I wanted to find out what is the output of that. Similarly, when I multiply S of T by sine 2 pi f c t, what is the output of that? Then let us see, by passing through some filter, I will be able to extract Si of T and as well as Sq of T. Hope you understood my intention. After getting the terms, multiplying it through cosine of that one, if I pass via low pass filter, then I will be able to get the in phase component, that is Si of T. Yes, similarly,
so
yeah,
so the final Si of T after it passes through LPF would be 2 Si of T cos square 2 f 2 pi f c t, sir.
No, after passing it through I will get only Si of T. The terms which are there at higher frequencies will be removed by the low pass filter, no?
Okay, sir.
Sir, yeah, after multiplying, what you are getting, is it possible to say? Yeah. See, yes. When I multiply S of T by 2 cos 2 pi f c t, what I get, man? What is the output of multiplier 1?
Sir, is it Si of T into 1 plus cos 4 pi f c t minus Sq of T into sine 4 pi f c t?
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. What you said is correct. So, we are getting Si of T plus Si of T into cos 4 pi f c t minus Sq of T into sine 4 pi f c t, right? The terms which are appearing at, means I am passing through the low pass filter now. So Si of T into cos 4 pi f c t minus Sq of T into sine 4 pi f c t will be filtered out by the low pass filter. So I will be able to get only the first term, that is Si of T. What Navreen has said is exactly correct. Hope others have done in the same way. Yes, I want response. Others have done what Navreen has said. Everybody has got the terms like that. Or you want me to do?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, others people should respond, not just Akshay, Navreen or Skanda or something, right? Many people are there now. 50 plus is the strength. 60 plus, 64. Yes, what about Neeraj? Have you done, man? I need not ask Neeraj. I think he should respond.
Yes, sir. I've done.
You got that point?
Yes,
Si
sir.
Of T, what are the terms? Huh? Yes, what about Anand?
Sir, Martha. No,
what is it now?
No, Martha.
Have you done, man? Huh?
Sir, I'm doing, sir.
In Kerala, what is it? ಇನ್ನು ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದೀಯಾ? ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ರೆ ಹೆಂಗ? ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲಿಕೇಶನ್ ಸೇ ಅದನ್ ಇಟ್ ಬಿಕಮ್ಸ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಲೋ ನಾ ಮೈ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಅದರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ ಸ್ಪೀಡ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಶುಡ್ ಸಿಂಕ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಎವ್ರಿ ಒನ್ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಸೇ ಮಲ್ಟಿಪ್ಲೈ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಎಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಟಿ ಬೈ 2 into cos 2 pi FCT, people should be able to do that very quickly. How Naureen could able to say the answer? See, output of multiplier 1. Output of multiplier 1 is what I said, S of T is multiplied by what? Into cos 2 pi FCT, right? So what is S of T? It is SI of T, right? Cos 2 pi FCT minus SU of T sine 2 pi FCT. Entire thing is multiplied by 2 into cos 2 pi FCT. Okay. So now is what I can write, 2 into what? SI of T into cos 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FCT is nothing but cos square 2 pi FCT, yes or no? Minus 2 into SQ of T into sine 2 pi FCT into cos 2 pi FCT. Okay. So you all know what is cos square theta. Right? That you need to substitute here. Just I will say cos square theta. Then here it is 2 sine theta into cos theta. For this, if you take, if you write first SQ of T, then 2 sin theta into cos theta. So I am using those two things. So what I can write here is, I will write here itself. So cos square theta. Yes, anyone of you can say what is cos square theta can be written as? Yes, this also you can't answer. Other students.
1 minus cos
square theta. Who is that answering? Somebody said na something.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. Hey, what man? Respond, man. What is this? These basic things also can't tell.
Sir, 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2, sir.
What? Cos square theta? What, man, Amita?
So 1 plus cos
2
theta by
2. Cos square. Yeah, basic answer that. Cos square theta will be 1 plus. Idella barita hodra kashta nanu. 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. Okay. I should write these things here. We know that cos square theta will be equal to 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2. And another one is what? 2 sin theta into cos theta. Okay, 2 sin theta into cos theta will be equal to what? Sin 2 theta. Theta. Sin, huh? Yes, sin 2 theta. I'm just substituting 2 sin theta into cos theta is sin 2 theta. Yes, any doubt? Any question in this? So I'm writing for this term. 2 sin theta into cos theta as sin 2 theta, I am going to write. Okay. So just you have to substitute that and simplify. So if I substitute above things, above standard this one, so what I can write is so So first term is what? 2 into, right? See, cos square theta is what? 1 plus cos 2 theta by 2, na? 2 into si of t of what? 1 plus cos 2 theta is nothing but 2 into, I hope you want me to write like that, or if I write 2 fct is 4 by fct is fine. No, the people understanding. Cos 2 theta. Okay, 2 into 2 pi fct by 2 it is. Okay. Then minus sq of t. Right, sq of t into what I said, 2 sin theta into cos theta can be written as sin 2 theta. So with that I can write sin 4 pi fct. Sin 4 pi fct. Okay. So further, I can simplify this as what? Hope shall I write the final term? We'll be able to understand. At least this simplification, 2 into si of t by 2, 2 2 will get cancelled. You want me to write that also? The first term, then next one is what? 2 into si of t into cos 4 pi fct by 2, then minus, right, the remaining term, that is sq of t sin 4 pi fct. Sin 4 pi fct. Really what we wanted to say is this two will get cancelled, this two and this two will get cancelled, right? So what are the remaining terms? The remaining terms will be what? Si of t, the first term, plus the second one is what? Si of t cos 4 pi fct, then minus sq of t sin 4 pi fct. Okay, 4 pi fct. So this is the term what I am getting at the output of the multiplier 1. So now I want si of t, right? What I need to do? I need to this through a low pass filter. So when I pass it through a low pass filter, what is happening? So the terms which are there at the higher frequencies, right, will be filtered out. Right? So the low pass filter will be eliminating these terms. So output of the low pass filter is what? Only si of t. Okay. So low pass filter, low pass will be filtering these terms. Low pass filter terms. Low pass filter terms. So what I can say is it will be only si of t. I hope this is fine. Yes, at least for this also you can't say yes sir, okay, fine, we have,
it's fine sir,
got idea and all. You want to say that also I should ask. See, I said I need some response. The output of low pass filter, output of low pass filter is what? This si of t. Okay. So in the same way, you can do for the lower multiplier. Okay. Hope you will be able to do that. So that will be the task what I am giving for today's this one. Okay. So do the same thing. Multiply s of t by minus 2 into sine 2 pi fct. Again, use the same basics. That is, I think here you may be getting sin square theta. You all know what is sin square theta. Anyone of you can say what is sin square theta?
1 minus cos 2 theta.
Yeah, 1 minus cos 2 theta by 2. Okay. Only that you need to substitute. In the same way, you will get here also the terms like what?
Sir, is the answer
sq of t
minus sq of
t? You will get sq of t minus sq of t cos 4 pi f c t minus si of t into
sin
4 pi f c t. So the terms which are there at higher frequencies will be filtered out by the low pass filter. You will get only sq of t. Okay. Hope you will be able to do by yourself in the same way.
Yes,
I expect
sir.
You
yes,
to show the answer, yes, okay? Sir. Because it is already 10:28. I expect you people to do the simplification. See how I have done step by step now. In the same way, I expect you to do for the output of the multiplier 2. Okay, similarly, what I can say, output of multiplier 2. Okay, output of multiplier 2 is what you can write, that is equal to what? S of t, right, into what? Minus 2 sin 2 pi f c t. Okay, just substitute the value of S of t and then multiply, okay, then simplify, okay. So if you do it, then what I can say, I said I will be getting what terms? Sq of t, right, minus, just I am writing the final answer, okay, Sq of t cos 4 pi f c t, then minus what, si of t into sine 4 pi fct. So the final answer will be what? Sq of t. Okay. So these terms will be low pass filter. So this is the output of the low pass filter. Okay, so we call this scheme as analyzer. Anyone of you can say why it is called analyzer? I said the above scheme may be referred as what? Analyzer. Why it is called analyzer? It's an important this one. Why it is called analyzer? Anyone of you can say what you have understood from the above theme? I'm saying whatever the scheme I have presented now, that is known as analyzer. Just quickly with this, I will stop. Yes? Analyzer. See what we have extracted, man, from baseband, from bandpass signal. See, we could extract the in-phase and quadrature component, SI of t and SQ of t, from the bandpass signal. So that is why it is called analyzer. So where do you think that this type of block diagram will appear, whether it is at the transmitter side or at the receiver side? Yes, I am asking you people only. Where do you think that this scheme will be used, whether at the transmitter side or at the receiver side? Yes?
Receiver.
Receiver side, very good. Who is that? Ananda?
Sir. No, sir.
Huh?
Yes. Yes, sir.
At least one fellow is getting this point, right? See, S of T is a bandpass signal, right? So this is a modulated signal. So obviously what I can say is this will be at the receiver side. Okay. So SI of T and SQ of T are basically the low pass signals, right? So we want information at the receiver side, right? Right. So this is the what the standard thing which is followed in the most of the communication systems. Okay. So with this, I will stop my lecture. So all of you write your USN in the chat box. How come now the strength has become 62? It was 57 only. I know who has joined.